build systems, huh? I recently created my own build system for C, in C. But first, a bit of context. There are many ways to build your C projects. The simplest way is to create a simple build script, such as this build.sh, where we compile main.c, set main as the output, and then execute it. To this, you can progressively update by, for example, adding flags. Here, dash wall adds warnings and dash g adds debug symbols. You can also link libraries. Here we add our local Raylib dependency. Link the necessary libraries for Raylib like OpenGL and etc. And if you were to want to compile more files, you can just add them like this. You could, for the rest of the life of a project, keep it in a simple build.sh file, which would mostly work, and for small projects or stuff you would only use yourself, this is the simplest and most effective solution. Another simple solution is GNU Make, which works very similar to this and helps you automate your build process. Here's our initial example in Make. This isn't too different to the previous example apart from cleaning your build files after running, so here's a more complex example. Here we first define the compiler, GCC. We add some C flags like before, some link flags, our target directory, which now is build, the source files we had before, and objs, which grabs the source files we gave it and adds a .o at the end, which would look like this. As you can see, main.c becomes main.o, file.c becomes file.o, etc. And after that, we basically compile all the files as objs and then link. The syntax is a bit weird and less legible, understandable since Make was created on the 70s, and it was the first build system, so there were no other inspirations. The good thing about Make is that by creating all these objs and then linking them, we get incremental builds, which means that when we make changes to our code, Make will only recompile the files that have changed since the last build. So the first time we build, it will take some time, but afterwards, if you make some tiny change in some file, it will only recompile that file, and the rest will not be recompiled. Recently, Ninja files were created, which are similar to Make files and serve the main purpose, but are faster and support parallel builds by default, which Make does support, but you have to add some extra parameters. The good thing about parallel builds is that you can utilize multiple CPU cores to compile different C files at the same time. Ninja files are a bit more verbose, but in a way more legible than Make files. Here's the previous example, but in Ninja. One reason for the verbosity is that by default, Ninja files were made to be fast to parse and to run, so complex syntax was not an option. They were created by Google because they needed a faster build system for Chrome. The Chrome codebase had grown so large that incremental builds were taking 10 to 20 minutes using the existing build systems. After implementing Ninja, build times were reduced dramatically to around 10 seconds for incremental builds, making developer iteration way more efficient. In Ninja's official site, they say, "Ninja's low-level approach makes it perfect for embedding into more featureful build systems." And by that they mean CMake, and other build systems which I will not mention because it would make this video 10 hours long. CMake is a lot higher level and allows you to create platform-independent build configurations. CMake acts as a meta build system that generates build files for various platforms. It abstracts away the platform-specific details, allowing developers to write a single build configuration that works everywhere, or at least that's the idea. Here you have the equivalent build script in CMake, which looks pretty similar apart from you having to set the CMake version and project name at the top. If you wanted to make this more generic, you would fetch Raylib with CMake itself. Here, fetch content downloads the latest release of Raylib and compiles it. And to make it more cross-platform, you would add different flags for each compiler or each OS, which would allow you to use the best compiler based on your platform. But I always wondered why in all of these options we use other languages or different syntax from C itself and not use C to build our project. Some of you probably already thought about nob.h, which is exactly what I described, a build system for C in C. Here's a simple nob build script. First, we rebuild the build script if we changed it, else we make there if build directory does not exist. Then we create our build command, compile it, and that's it. If you want, you can even compile many files asynchronously with command run, async, and reset. Similar similar to Ninja's Sparrow build. I'll leave that example in the description in case you're interested. One interesting disadvantage of nob mentioned in their GitHub page is that you have to be comfortable with C and in implementing things by yourself, which is what the sponsor of today's video is for. Brilliant allows you to learn at your own pace complex topics in a simple way. You can choose from a vast array of topics, from computer science to math to problem solving and more, with thousands of interactive lessons, which are ideal if you're looking to expand your knowledge. With Brilliant, you get smarter every day, which is important nowadays to stay up to date as a programmer. It also helps build your critical thinking skills through problem solving and not memorizing, which I respect quite a bit. It's also a very effective way to actually learn topics, since their content is created by professionals from MIT, Galtech, Google, etc. So to try everything for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/Ilovowski or scan the QR code on screen, or you can click on the link in the description. You'll get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Going back to nob, the problem with it is that it is more of a scripting library which helps you to create your build scripts than a build system. So by default, it does not have incremental builds, nor other forms of caching, nor parallel builds. So you can implement all of those by yourself. If you want to make your build scripts cross-platform, you would have to add something like this, which is similar to the approach CMake takes. But I kind of wished something like Zig.build existed, but in C. The Zig build system, in my opinion, is the best build system of the bunch, at least for now. But the clear problem is that it is in Zig, and I don't want to be writing Zig. There's a reason why I'm still using C. So inspired by the Zig build system, nob, CMake, and other libraries, I created mate.h, a build system for C in C as God intended. It uses Ninja files under the hood, so it's not completely standalone yet, but that adds all the advantages of Ninja files, like incremental builds, parallel builds, and you get to use just C. To use it first, get on the repository and download mate.h, add it to your root directory, and create a mate.c file as well. In the mate.c build file, you include mate.h, define the implementation macro, so that's the definitions of functions. Then you define the main function, and similar to Raylib, where you use begin drawing and end drawing, here we have start build and end build. Inside, you can create the executable and the flex you want to use. Add the files you want to compile, which will compile parallelly and incrementally. Add includes libraries and link system libraries, and then you install the executable, which under the hood runs Ninja. This function returns the path to where the executable is at, and you can just run it. Of course, to run this script, you need a C compiler, so you can compile mate.c like this. Afterwards, you can just run it automatically, like .-mate, and if you were to make any change, it will automatically rebuild itself like nob does. You can also see the equivalent Ninja files it generates and how it works in the build directory. Before you go out and try it, this is still very experimental, so don't expect it to work in all platforms, though I'll gladly take any PRs if you want to contribute on it. The point of this library is to write build scripts that run on all platforms with different compilers. Sometimes I want to make stuff on Windows with MSPC and then run it on Linux with GCC. And this fixes my problem. But honestly, I also just wanted to reinvent the wheel like we all do and have my own tool. But for using different compilers, we would have to create different flags depending on the compiler, which would look like this. But to avoid this, you can set more generic flags instead of specific ones. Here we add warnings as flag all warnings and debug as flag debug, and depending on the compiler, it adds the appropriate flags, which are equivalent for each compiler. Also, the library itself has a lot of utility functions that make it easier to write your scripts, like file read or read directory, if you wanted to compile all your source files, for example. I plan to maintain it for a long time, so if you like the idea of it, give it a star and check it out in the future. Maybe by then it's more stable, or you might already be in the future. What do I know? This is all for this video, so get out.